briefly just gonna make mention that if you pick up that iGrow wheat book or the handles that we're gonna pass out, you're gonna see this chart in here. you're gonna see this chart in there, and it's gonna help you figure out when to scout for these certain diseases. Not every disease that we can get in South Dakota is listed on here. These are more of those major ones that we're gonna see, more of the economical ones. And you know, since we've kind of put this chart together, we've had a few that have sprung up the last couple of years, so we're gonna have to add them kind of back into the scouting calendar. But anyhow, we show the different growth stages and we show the different diseases to look for. The yellow is when you would really wanna look for it, when you'd see them. And when we talk about the different stages, we can go ahead and put that down. You know, we'll go ahead and just, you know, kind of look at that. But when we talk about the different stages, you know, first thing, when you start to look at your wheat, really when should you put on that fungicide for that very first time? Well, there's been a lot of talk about doing a half rate of fungicide at tillering. I'd really encourage against that. If you have to make a fungicide application at tillering time or at that early season, use that full rate, because what we're doing, if we're continually putting on that half rate of fungicide, whether or not disease is present, we are inducing opportunity for resistance to develop. And so I encourage you not to do that, but I'd really encourage you to take a look at where your wheat is planted. You know, so much as when you look at the stubble, what did you plant wheat into? Is it wheat on wheat? Is it wheat on corn? Is it wheat into soybeans? You know, what is wheat planted into? If it's planted into wheat, I would encourage you to take a look that you may have to use an early season fungicide application if there's some disease pressure going on. The other thing you want to take a look at is what variety of wheat did you plant? Is it susceptible? Is it moderately susceptible? Does it have some resistance? You know, that is an already inbred part of the package. You know, take a look into that. If you have more of a susceptible variety, you may have to use that early season application. But the third thing that I really want to encourage you to take a look at, and we've kind of hit it home throughout the session today, is that environment. Have we had some rainfall? What is the temperature? If you have that conducive environment, the right conditions conducive for disease, you can spread problems, and we would encourage you to use a fungicide treatment if necessary. Now, when you go out into the field, you may see some light infection. That's tolerable. We can handle a little bit of infection. You know, that's normal. Some out there is okay. But if you're starting to see a lot and it's starting to advance to economic levels, then you may need to use a fungicide. And that's, you know, looking at those early season diseases like tan spot, the steganosporas, the powdery mildew, and the different like stripe rust. When we kind of move on into the next application time, that's pretty key for wheat, is our flag leaf. You know, it protects our yield. When we look at that flag leaf, not only look at the flag leaf, but look at flag minus one, so the leaf directly below flag leaf, or two leaves directly below the flag leaf. You know, roughly about 10% of the leaf area on flag minus one could warrant a fungicide application if disease pressure is there, or 20% on flag minus two. You know, so take a look at what's happening on that flag minus one and flag minus two, and take a look around in the area. You know, are you starting to see some of those leaf spotting diseases, some of the rusts? You know, what's going on out there? And again, if you have a variety that has some resistance to the rusts, you would not necessarily at this time have to use a fungicide control for rust, but you would have to apply it for the different leaf diseases that are occurring out in the fields. Moving on, Emmanuel touched base on Fusarium head blight. That is our big time that we would apply a fungicide at that, you know, it's after it's headed, it's when it started to flower. We have that limited window of protection for scab or for our Fusarium head blight control. When we look at our scab, you know, it's that limited window. Again, take into account, are we having that moisture? Is it warm? You know, what is that temperature? If it's dry and hot, we don't have to worry about that. You know, but if we're having some moisture, really kind of pay attention to what's going on in the area, because if it's hot and dry, we won't have that infection occur. If you start, you know, you've had some dew, you've put on a fungicide, and we'll take a quick walk if there's time before, as you move on to your next session, at our plots here, we'll find that no fungicide is 100% effective against scab. You know, it's about 70% controls what you're going to get at optimal time. So when you're out there, you're going to see some in our check and you're going to see some in our fungicide treatments. It's just you're going to have less where we've applied the fungicide. Now, you'd want to scout. So after it's flowered or you've put on that fungicide, about 3 weeks later is when you're going to start to see those bleach spikelets, starting to see those awns or see the symptoms appear in the head. When you start to take a look, if you're seeing more than 10% scab develop, you may have a problem and have some elevated mycotoxin levels. The one that we're concerned about is Dawn. So you would want to explore your insurance or different marketing possibilities. There's different ways you would harvest. And the mycotoxin, you know, is regulated depending on how heavy the load is. You may have some dockage issues with that.